Hello everybody and welcome back to the Gamer Donnie channel here on YouTube. I'm Gamer Donnie and today we're going to play some American Truck Simulator. We're up here in Eden, Oklahoma. We got a load of fattening cows, 43,932 pounds. We're going to take it to Montrose, Colorado in this Freightliner Classic XL. Got the Detroit Series 60 with a 13 speed in it. And this is the Wilson Gold Line livestock hauling trailer. So it looks like we've got about 695 miles to go. It says it's going to take 13 and a half hours to get there. We'll see about that. Let's jump in here and fire this thing up. Well, it's already running. Let's get going. On the road again. Let's see what we can get into. Watch me drive on the wrong side of the road because I've been playing Euro Truck Simulator.
Turn left.
And we're off. Another great adventure in American Truck Simulator with Gamer Donnie.
Go straight.
Go straight, she says. How's everybody been doing out there? You guys doing pretty good? We've just been trucking around here. Trucking around.
Keep left. After 50 yards, turn left.
Nope, not there. Right, yeah.
Turn left.
Oh, come on, slow down. Set my NVIDIA game filter back up now that I'm using the JBX3. Which shit looks pretty damn good, I mean, don't get me wrong. But it can look a little bit better.
Go straight.
And something is tickling my damn leg. A cord. Hold on. Yeah, fingers. Mouse cord.
Go straight.
35. We're stopping at the Donut Planet. Get some donuts.
Go straight.
Might need them if we get pulled over. We can just give them a box of donuts. Right. That always works out good. 12:35 p.m. Says we should be there about 2 a.m. So, the last part of this trip is going to be dark. $50 now. Take you out a loan. But everything cranked up on high, so. Well, I don't have the reflections turned up on 200 scaling, because they're only at 100, but everything else is as high as it'll go. Through Oklahoma and Arkansas, actually.
Go straight.
And if I remember correctly, it goes all the way through northern Arkansas. So. Has been a while since I've been down through Arkansas. Arkansas. It's probably going to be two lane back roads or roads like this going through the small towns until we hit I-25. Then we'll run that north on up into Colorado. Yeah. That's the plan anyway. Then we'll have to start heading westbound there in Colorado. I don't know what road it is. Take us over there to Montrose, go down through the valley, up the hill, down through the valley.
Go straight.
This is John Ruta's Freightliner Classic, by the way. You're gonna do it, aren't you? Like I said, you better not be one of these jackasses that passes you and slows the hell down. Buddy! Really? Damn it, driver. Finally figured out why my graphics wasn't working as good, because I had the fucking V-Sync turned on. Don't turn that shit on. Leave that V-Sync off. Well, at least I can anyway. I got a 3070 TIOC overclocked video card. RTX. And it does the V-Sync through the NVIDIA's game experience. Automatically puts the V-Sync on there, so it's like trying to V-Sync to V-Sync, and it just wasn't working out. It dropped the frame rate way too damn low. I turned it off, I could run everything on high, and I had no problems, and everything looked good, so. Can't believe it took me so long to figure that out. But.
Go straight.
Glad I didn't figure it out.
straight.
Fix my fucking mouse cord because it's just killing me. Oh, there we go. Don't like things tickling me leg. Bad enough that damn day's got some big ass bar down there I stub my toe on all the time.
Go straight.
I shall cut it off one of these days. Then the whole desk will probably fall apart. They gonna fight? Cat fight. Bone, we're burning fuel. 0.6 gallons an hour.
Go straight.
This thing's actually getting 5.2 miles per gallon. That's pretty damn good for this truck. I could probably squeeze more out if I drive halfway decent.
Go straight.
Dream burger, prime rib. Man, I'm getting hungry now. Oh, we got here little shepherds. I used to actually live next door to a place in Little Shepherds, run by some Amish people. It's like a bed and breakfast type thing. There were damn horses shitting all over the road. I used to live up here in Indiana. Lived there for about 8 years. Got tired of all the damn snow and the cold. So I moved me south back down south. Now it's just hot and humid. How we doing on fuel? Oh, we still got a full tank of fuel. I think I just bought this truck too, actually. Yeah, it only got 324 miles on it.
Turn right.
Car zone. Get in the zone. Yeah, there's truck stop over there too. Yeah, you don't want to be shifting gears while you're turning like that now with a load of cows on. Or any livestock. You jerk them all to one side and they'll roll your trailer over. Seen it happen before. not a very pretty sight. Pigs everywhere. Top of the trailer split open. Pigs just running all over the damn place. Is a JBX graphics and weather pack for a Euro Truck Simulator here a while back. I didn't know you could use it on American Truck Simulator too. So when you don't read.
Keep right. After 50 yards, go straight.
But apparently you can, so we're using it.
Go straight.
Some reason I don't think it looks as good as Euro Truck Simulator 2 does, but I haven't really drove much since I put it in. I've been driving around in Russia and Japan, everywhere in between. Well, it's good to be back in American Truck Simulator. Sometimes you just gotta take a break from it. Up here in Colorado, we'll only be able to see what it looks like. It should look pretty good. All the trees and everything. There he is, sitting there waiting. Good thing there's a little hill there that slowed us down.
Go straight.
I tried to use some of those traffic packs or traffic mods, you know, that changes the density and all that shit of traffic. They just, for some reason, they just don't run good. I mean, they're not terrible. I mean, I could deal with it if I had to, but you know. And I know there's CPU. They use a lot of the CPU up, but I got a 32 core, 64 thread, Threadripper 4.0, which overclocks itself right up to 6. So I know it's not the GPU, or the CPU, I mean, because I'm not even using 1% of it.
Keep right.
Somebody did say that the American Truck Simulator only uses one core, or was it one or two cores, but I put in the command line so it'll use all of them and it'll split it up. I just haven't ever really had luck with the traffic densities mods. But yeah, I know the computer's overkill for gaming, but when I bought it, I didn't buy it too as a gaming PC. I bought it as a, you know, like a workstation, do 3D models and create animations and little videos and stuff like that. does put off quite a bit of heat, though. I will say that. The whole top of the computer, it's, let's say, eight inches wide. Probably 2.5, maybe 3 foot long. The whole top of it's one big radiator. It got three big fans that blows the air out the top of it. I got four fans at the front of it sucking cold air in. One fan that's blowing it out the back. For sucking it in from the back, I mean. It does heat up the room. I wish I could change the LOD so it'd load in a little bit further out. It'd make it look better. Oh, Mac dump truck. We've got two of them in there. Big old stack sticking out. I spend way too much money on these fucking truck driving games. Yeah, then the steering wheel, the gear shifter, the button box. Way too damn much. But I really enjoy playing them. Train. Give me a minute, we'll get some speed picked up here.
Go straight.
Get in there. Stopped in time. So we should be shifting right around 1700-1800 RPM. Turbo's working overtime. I am using Project NextGen's road texture pack because it looks good. A lot better than what the JBX default shit is. skybox looks good though. That'll be 108 different skyboxes, I believe. Shit, that sign said 75 back there. Oh, that's right. Damn it, I didn't take the fucking speed limit thing out. Mod. So it's always going to say 60. It won't ever go above 60. It's some stupid mod for the Mexico part. Reforma. Scared the shit out of me. One of those Suzuki's. I think they're called Hino's. H-I-N-O. Hino. Got the little poor banger in it. Four-cylinder diesel engines put out quite a bit of torque.
Go straight.
I'm going to say probably about 75. Turn some headlights on. We don't want to get a ticket for that shit. traffic come from? Ain't that just beautiful? Flying through there, Tanky Ganger. We ain't no hurry. Well, we're what, about halfway there? Say there's a certain times of day that this game just looks really fucking good. Smooth. bam. The blue truck maker's only been trying to pass us for the last 20 miles. What the hell is that? Oh, little fly shit. Wipe that off there. I do believe we're about to enter Colorado. Green light. That's what we like to see.
Keep left.
It's gonna be nighttime when we hit Colorado. We're not gonna be able to see shit. Some lights on, so we see what the hell's going on.
right. After 50 yards, exit right ahead. Exit right ahead. Turn left. Keep left. After 50 yards, turn left. Turn left.
Tank. Not sure we got half tank. That'll get us there. Say one thing, I like the nighttime on the JBX. It makes it brighter, like it's more realistic. At least when you're looking out your side windows, you can actually see the road and the ground. That's one reason I hated driving at nighttime. I took 40 on over and went up through Farmington and up the Million Dollar Highway to go to Montrose, but we didn't. Would have been about the same distance. Thinking about it, I was watching him. Seventh. Wouldn't that be something to add break fade to this game? People wouldn't be driving so fucking crazy then. didn't make our 130 ETA, but we still should be there pretty good. It says 230, so we're about an hour off. Actually, right here's Montrose.
Go straight.
Hard left. Like we're going to be in this lane over here.
Go straight.
Good old town of Montrose, Colorado. This is usually, I picked this as my starting place, my home base, most of the time. So I like the curvy, snaky mountain roads. I like a good challenge. And drop them off at the store, huh?
You
like that barbecue
you're
sitting out there. Looks pretty nice. There we go. 696 miles, 14 hours, 50 minutes, 151.5 gallons of fuel consumed. We only got $8,462 off that. I got ripped the fuck off. Damn.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.